starting the third seminar of the seminar series organized by the Bank of Ceylon under the Nanajaya program. Today my discussion is focused on the fifth lesson of the syllabus, National Accounting Estimates. We will start the discussion. Before moving to the question, I will give a brief explanation regarding the National Accounting Estimates. During this lesson, we are learning how to estimate the value of goods and services a country produced during a given period of time. Right? We define the gross domestic product of a country as the total market value of all the final goods and services produced within an economic territory during a given period of time. Gross domestic product of a country refers to the total market value of all the final goods and services produced within an economic territory during a given period of time. So, in order to estimate the value of goods and services, we are using three approaches under this National Accounting Estimates: the output approach, income approach, and then the expenditure approach. So, in order to get an approach to these three methods of estimating the value of gross domestic product, I'm talking about the circular flow of income in my first question, PVC. Draw a circular flow of income which shows the flow of goods and services and the factors of production between households and production firms. Show the financial flows also on the same diagram. We will see. We know that the households are the ones who hold the ownership of land, labor, capital, entrepreneurship in a market economy. So the households are providing their factors of production to the production firms. So therefore, factors of production are flown from the factor ownership is there with the households in the economy. So the households will be providing their factors of production to the production firms. So therefore, there will be a flow of factors of production from the households to the production firms. So in return to the supply of factors of production, there will be a flow of factor incomes. There will be a flow of factor incomes . So these factor incomes will be comprising of rent, wages, interest, and then profits. Right? Factors of production are flown from households to the production firms, and in return, factor incomes, rent, wages, interest, and profits, right? Rent, wages, interest, and profits will be flown from the production firms to the households. Factors of production are flown from the households to the production firms, and in return, the factor incomes are flown from the production firms to the households. What do the households do with their income? They will be spending on the income earned by the households will be spent by the households on purchasing goods and services to the from the production firms. So there will be a flow of expenditure. There will be a flow of expenditure. On goods and services, there will be a flow of expenditure on goods and services from the households to the production firms. There will be a flow of expenditure from households to the production firms on goods and services. In return, the goods and services, in return, the goods and services are transferred from production firms to the households. Goods and services are transferred from the production firms to the households. So this is identified as the circular flow of income. The factors of production flown from households to the production firms, and then the goods and services flown from the production firms to the households are identified as the real flows. The goods and services flown from production firms to the households, and then the factors of production flown from households to the production firms are identified as the real flows in this circular flow of income diagram. To the other way, the factor incomes flown from production firms to the households, and then the expenditure incurred by the households on purchasing goods and services are identified as the money flows, or in other words, the financial flows in this circular flow of income. The financial flows in this circular flow of income. Right? The factors of production flown from households to the production firms, the goods and services flown from production firms to the households are identified as the real flows of the circular flow of income. To the other way, the factor incomes received by the households from the production firms, the expenditure incurred by households on production firms on goods and services are identified as the money flows, or in other words, the financial flows of this circular flow of income. As I already told you, what do we mean by the gross domestic product of a country? Gross domestic product is defined as the total market value of all the final goods and services produced within an economic territory during a given period of time. So in very simple terms, we are learning how to estimate the value of goods and services an economy produced during a given period of time during this lesson. So we are looking at the output of an economic territory from three different points of view under the national accounting estimates of a country: output approach, income approach, and then the expenditure approach. Under the output approach, we are estimating the value of goods and services which are flown from the production firms to the households. Under the output approach, we are estimating the value of goods and services which are flown from the production firms to the households. And under the income approach, we are estimating the value of factor incomes flown from the production firms to the households. If production firms decided to generate a certain output, they will have to hire the same valued factors of production from the factor suppliers. In other words, the households. So therefore, the value of output is estimated under the income approach based on the factor incomes generated by the households by providing their land, labor, capital, entrepreneurship to the production process during the given period of time. And under the expenditure approach, we are estimating this flow of expenditure on goods and services flown from households to the production firms. Under this, we are estimating the value of output of the country based on the expenditure incurred on purchasing those goods and services during the given period of time. So we will go back to the question. Draw a circular flow of income which shows the flow of goods and services and factors of production between households and production firms. Show the financial flows on the same diagram. So we showed factors of production are flown from households to production firms. Goods and services are flown from production firms to households. So these two, the factors of production and then the goods and services, are identified as the real flows here. And then the factor incomes flown from production firms to the households, which includes rent, wages, interest and profits. And then the expenditure incurred by the households on the production firms are identified as the money flows, or in other words, the financial flows of this circular flow of income. So this is how we can explain the circular flow of income in relation to a simple economic model. So we will move on to the next question. Question number 2. What are the 3 approaches used to estimate the gross domestic product of a country? Explain how the same value is obtained from all these 3 approaches. As I explained in the previous question 2, under the national accounting estimates, we used 3 approaches to estimate the value of the gross domestic product of the country. We use 3 approaches to estimate the value of the gross domestic product of the country: output approach, income approach, and then the expenditure approach. Under the output approach, we are looking from the producer's point of view and we estimate the value of the output of the country. Under the income approach, we are estimating the value of output of the country based on the factor payments made on hiring factors of production to produce these goods and services during the given period of time. So, for an example, if the producers of the economy produced a stock of goods and services worth of 5,000 million during a given year's period, they need to hire factors of production worth of 5,000 million in order to generate this output. So in one hand, when the producers are producing a stock of goods and services worth of 5,000 million, the factor suppliers are generating an income of 5,000 million during the same period of time. So under both of these things, we are looking at the same thing. We are looking at the value of output of the country from 2 different points of view, 2 different dimensions. So therefore, we are estimating the same thing from 2 different points of view means what? We must end up with the same value. Under the expenditure approach, what do? under the expenditure approach, what do? We are estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Under the expenditure approach, we are estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country based on the expenditure incurred on purchasing these goods and services during the given period of time. Right. So if the producers of the economy produced a stock of goods and services worth of 5,000 million, they need to hire factors of production worth of 5,000 million. So the factor owners should have generated a total factor income of 5,000 million during the period being considered. And to the other way, when a stock of goods and services worth of 5,000 million are presented to presented in the market for sale, the buyers, the consumers of the economy, should have spent 5,000 million rupees in order to purchase these goods and services during the given period of time. So under all the three approaches, we are looking at the same thing, just from three different points of view, three different dimensions. Therefore, we should arrive at the same answer under all the three approaches. So we will move on to the answer. The three approaches used to measure the gross domestic product of a country are output approach, income approach, and then the expenditure approach. So we will see how to explain the fact that all these three approaches are giving the same answer. Output, income, and expenditure approaches are three dimensions of the same process. I explain. Under the output approach, we are looking from the producer's point of view. Under the income approach, we are looking from the factor supplier's point of view. And under the expenditure approach, we are looking from the consumer's point of view. But at last, we are estimating the value of same output during the period being considered. So see, the total value of all the final goods and services produced within a certain given year's period of time is measured under the output approach. Right? The total value of all factor payments made to production factors which were used to produce those final goods and services is measured under the income approach. The total value of output is essentially equal to the total factor payments made to generate that output. Right? So through that we are explaining that the output approach and the income approach are giving the same answer. Therefore, the value obtained from both the output approach and income approach should be equal to each other. Also, the total expenditure spent on purchasing those final goods and services is measured under the expenditure approach. The value of output should be essentially equal to the amount spent to purchase that output. Therefore, the value obtained from output and expenditure approaches should also be equal to each other. So this is how we can explain that all the three approaches used to estimate the gross domestic product of the country are giving the same answer. Right. We will move on to the next question. Right. So before moving to the question, I will give you a brief explanation regarding the economic activities and how these economic activities should be categorized when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Why is it? The question is, state whether the following events are included or not in estimating the gross domestic product of a country. Briefly explain your answer. So currently, we are estimating the national accounting estimates of Sri Lanka. Currently, we are estimating the national accounting estimates of Sri Lanka based on SNA 2008 guidelines. So when we are identifying which activities or which economic activities should be taken into consideration when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country, and then which activities are disregarded when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country, we should follow up the guidelines issued by the SNA 2008 guidelines. So the economic activities which are taken place during the given period of time, economic activities which are taken place during a given period of time can be divided into two categories as productive economic activities and then non-productive economic activities. Productive economic activities and then non-productive economic activities. Right? The economic activities can be divided into two broader categories as productive economic activities and then the non-productive economic activities. First of all, we will see what is meant by the non-productive economic activities. We will see what is meant by the non-productive economic activities. Non-productive economic activities are the economic activities which do not create a new value addition to the economy, the economic activities which does not contribute for a new good or a service only are identified as the non-productive economic activities. We divide these non-productive economic activities into three categories, or in other words, we identify three types of non-productive economic activities. Completely financial nature transactions, completely financial nature transactions, sale of used goods, and then transfer payments. Right? Non-productive economic activities are divided into three categories as completely financial nature transactions, sale of used goods, and then the transfer payments. As I already told you, what do we mean by the non-productive economic activities? The non-productive economic activities are the economic activities which do not contribute to a new good or a service. So, as these activities are not contributing to a new good or a service, if we can identify a given economic activity as a non-productive economic activity, then we can directly come into a conclusion that these are not included when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. non-productive economic activities are the economic activities which does not contribute to a new good or a service. So, if we can identify a given economic activity as a non-productive economic activity, we should directly come into the conclusion that it is not there inside the GDP of the country. Completely financial nature transactions, sale of used goods, and then the transfer payments are the examples, are the categories of the non-productive economic activities. Completely financial nature transactions refer to the transactions which are associated with the financial instruments. Buying shares of a company, selling shares of a company, buying treasury bills, treasury bonds, debentures. All these transactions which are associated with financial instruments only are identified as the completely financial nature transactions. So through these kind of completely financial nature transactions, we will not be able to identify a new good or a service. They do not contribute to a new good or a service during the given period of time. So if we can identify the given economic activity as a completely financial nature transaction, then it will be identified as a non-productive economic activity, and therefore it is not there inside the GDP of the country. We don't take that into consideration. And then the sale of used goods. Now think of a house which is being constructed before 5 years. At that respective year in which it is constructed, it is a new good for the economy during that year's period. And that should have already taken into consideration when estimating the gross domestic product of that respective year. But after 5 years' time, when the same house is sold by the owner, the current owner, to some other party of the economy, the only thing what happens is the ownership of that house is transferred from one person to another person of the economy. From the overall economic system's point of view, when we see that does not create a new good or a service to the economy during the given period of time. So it is treated as a non-productive economic activity. And then the transfer payments. Transfer payments are the one-way payments made by one party to another party. Now, if you take an employee who is working to the government, a public sector employee. So for a certain month's period when he provides his labor to the government for some kind of a government institution, at the end of the month, the government pays him the salary. He works to the government, he provides his labor to the government, and then government compensates it by paying a salary. But after some time, when this public sector employee is retired, the government may pay him a pension payment, right? He doesn't work for that month, but at the end of the month, the government offers him the pension payment, right? So even though this person receives this pension income, that pension income received by him does not create a new good or a service to the economy, does not create a new value addition to the economy. So they are these kind of one-way payments. They are just receiving and they don't do anything. Parents might be offering some pocket money for their children. For that, the children are not supposed to do anything. Means they are not supposed to create some good or a service through that. So these kind of payments, one-way payments, are identified as the transfer payments. These are also not creating a new good or a service to the economy during the given period of time. So these are identified as the transfer payments. So if you can identify a given economic activity as a completely financial nature transaction, a sale of used good, or as a transfer payment, we can then say that it is not included in the GDP of the country. But then, just because the activity being considered is productive, we will see what is meant by a productive economic activity. An economic activity which creates a new good or a service to the economy, which contributes to a new good or a service to the economy during the given period of time, is what we identify as a productive economic activity. An economic activity which creates a new good or a service to the economy during the given period of time is what we identify as a productive economic activity. But I told you at the beginning of this discussion that we are supposed to estimate the national accounting estimates based on the SNA 2008 guidelines, System of National Accounts 2008 guidelines. So, the concept of production boundary is introduced here to identify which productive economic activities are included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country, and then which productive economic activities are excluded when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. So we can divide these productive economic activities into two subcategories. As productive activities covered through production boundary, and then the productive economic activities not covered through the production boundary. Right? So the productive economic activities are further divided into two as the productive activities covered through production boundary and then productive activities which are not covered through the production boundary. Even though the activity being considered is productive, if it is not covered through the production boundary, again we should say that it is not there inside the GDP of the country. Even though the activity being considered is productive, if it is not covered through the production boundary, right, we don't take that into consideration when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Only the productive economic activities which are covered through the production boundary, are taken into consideration when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. So see, the economic activities are divided into two categories: productive economic activities and then non-productive economic activities. Non-productive economic activities are the economic activities which does not create a new good or which do not create a new good or a service to the economy. They do not contribute to a new good or a service. They do not create a new value addition to the economy. The non-productive economic activities are of three types: the completely financial nature transactions, sale of used goods, and then the transfer payments. If we can come into a conclusion that the economic activity being considered is non-productive, then we should say that it is not there inside the GDP of the country. It is disregarded when estimating the gross domestic product of the country. Right. Then, as we discussed, what do we mean by productive economic activities? they are the economic activities which create a new good or a service to the economy. The economic activities which create a new value addition to the economy only are identified as the productive economic activities. But we divide these productive economic activities into two categories, as productive activities covered through the production boundary, and then the productive economic activities which are not covered through the production boundary. Only the productive economic activities which are covered through the production boundary are included in estimating the gross domestic product of the country. The productive economic activities which are covered through the production boundary are identified, can be identified under three categories, as market aimed producers. These are the economic activities, productive activities which are covered through the production boundary. Market aimed producers. Non-market producers. And then producers for self-consumption. The productive economic activities which are covered through production boundary are divided into three. Market aim producers. Any good or a service produced aiming on selling in the market for a price is identified as market aim producers. So the goods and services which are produced with the view of selling in the market only are identified as the market aim producers. Right? So therefore, if we can identify any productive economic activity as a market aim production activity, a good or a service produced with the view of selling in the market, we identify that as an activity which is included in estimating the gross domestic product of the country. And then the second one, what do we mean by the non-market producers? These are the goods and services produced in order to provide for the households of the economy, but without a motive of profit. Government sector provide the education services, but the government is usually not charging a price on them, and they are not expecting to make a profit by providing these services. The government provide the health services. Usually they don't charge a price for them, and they don't have an objective of making profits through that. There are some examples for non-market producers. So both the market-aimed producers as well as the non-market producers are covered through the production boundary. And then the third category is producers for self-consumption. Right? Producers for self-consumption. The goods, not the services, but the goods which are produced by the households in order to use for their consumption. The goods which are produced by the households which are used for their own consumption are identified under the producers for self-consumption. So, if you can identify any productive economic activity, under any of these three components, market-aimed producers, non-market producers, and then producers for self-consumption. Then we should say that it is included inside the gross domestic product of the country. It is simply included when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Right? So therefore, these are the three types of productive economic activities which are covered through the production boundary. But to the other way, the self-services, the services carried out by the individuals for their own consumption, washing clothes by individuals, preparing food by the family members to their family, right? And then maybe some family members are providing some transportation facilities to some other family members. The elderly people may be looked after by the family members. All these services are not carried out with an economic motive. These are identified as the self-services, or in other words, the do-it-for-yourself activities. So, if you can identify any given activity as a self-service, even though it is productive, it is not covered through the production boundary. Therefore, they are not there inside the GDP estimations of the country. So with this explanation, we will go to the question and we will see which activities are included in estimating the GDP and then which activities are not included in estimating the GDP of a country. Right, first one, health services provided by the government for free of charge. Health services provided by the government for free of charge. It's a productive activity because it creates a new service. But the government usually does not charge a price. But still, it is a new service provided by the government on behalf of the household's consumption, is gone under the non-market production activity. So we should conclude that it is included inside the GDP of the country. So what we should say here? The health services provided by the government for free of charge, you should say it is included. The reason is it is a non-market production activity, a productive economic activity, which is covered through the production boundary. Therefore, it is included in estimating the GDP of the country. Second one, purchase of newly issued shares of a company. Maybe these shares are newly issued shares by the company. Maybe these shares are some retrading shares of a company. Right? That is, maybe the person who purchases shares may be buying them directly from the company, which are newly issued shares. Or else maybe they are bought from the share market. Whatever it is, under this what happens is cash is transferred from one person to another person. Cash is transferred from one person to another person. In return, they are getting the ownership of shares of that respective company. That's it. But directly as a result of that transaction of buying shares of a company, a new good or a service is not created in the economy. Therefore, it is a completely financial nature transaction, a non-productive activity. Therefore, it is not included in estimating the GDP of the country. Third one, receipt of pension payments by a retired public employee. When the public sector employee is working to the government, when he provides his labor and getting his salary, it is a productive economic activity. But after he is retired, he is getting his pension income. But for that, he does not have to do anything to the government. Right? Without providing his labor, he is just getting an allowance from the government called pensions. Through that, a new good or a service is not created to the economy. A transfer payment, a non-productive economic activity. So you should say, it is not included in the GDP. This is a transfer payment, a non-productive economic activity. So it is not included in estimating the GDP. Fourth one, part of the harvest gained by a farmer for his personal use. Part of the harvest gained by a farmer for his personal use. So, if you can remember, we identified the economic activities which are covered through the production boundary under three categories. We divided the productive economic activities which are covered through the production boundary under three categories as market-aimed producers, non-market producers, and then producers for self-consumption. The producers for self-consumption identifies the goods which are produced with the view of using for their own consumption. So, the part of the harvest kept by a farmer for his personal use is also an example for a good produced for self-consumption. So, it is included in estimating the GDP of the country. So, we should say it is a good produced for self-consumption covered through production boundary. And therefore, it is included in estimating the GDP. Next one. Looking after elderly parents by family members. The family members are looking after the elderly people as a self-service, as a service provided to their own family. They do not have an economic motive of providing that respective service. They do not have an economic motive of providing that respective service. So we should say that it is a self-service, or in other words, it is a do-it-for-yourself activity not covered through the production boundary. Therefore, it is not included in estimating the GDP of the country. Next one. Commission income earned by a broker by selling a used house. So need to carefully see what they are talking about. See, commission income earned by a broker by selling a used house. So if the question or the statement is regarding the selling of used house, it is a sale of a used good. It is a sale of a used good. So definitely it is a non-productive economic activity and it is not covered through the production boundary. It is a non-productive economic activity. Therefore, we should say that it is not included in the gross domestic product of the country. But here, what do they say? Commission income earned by a broker by selling a used house. So the broker is providing a market-aimed service. What is his service? His business or his service is providing brokering services, right? So the respective broker might be finding out a prospective buyer of this house, do all the negotiations between the buyer and the seller, right? All the necessary services are provided to facilitate this transaction between the buyer and the seller. Sometimes he may be using his labor on this. He might be using his like maybe a vehicle to travel from here and there, right? So therefore, he is providing a market-aimed service. The commission income, which is earned by the broker by providing this brokering service, should therefore be treated as a market-aimed service, a productive activity covered through the production boundary, and therefore it is included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Need to carefully understand that this statement is not talking about the value of the house which is sold. If it is the sale of a used house, it is a non-productive economic activity and therefore it is not included in estimating the GDP. But the statement is regarding the commission income earned by the broker by providing the brokering service here. It is an income earned by providing a market-aimed service. Therefore, it is included in estimating the GDP of the country. Right. Next one. Value of vegetables cultivated in a home garden for family consumption. Value of vegetables. Vegetables is a good. So this is a good produced for the family consumption, self-consumption. we learned that the productive activities which are covered through the production boundary are of three types: market-tamed producers, non-market producers, and then producers for self-consumption. So this is a good produce for the self-consumption. Gone under the producers for self-consumption, covered through the production boundary. Therefore, it is included in estimating the gross domestic product of the country. So in your explanation, you should say this is a good produce for self-consumption. It is covered through the production boundary, and therefore it is included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Next one. Transport facilities provided by a father to his children. Transport facilities, a service provided by one family member to the other family members. The father does this, father provides this service to his family members not with an economic motive. A service provided by one family member to the other family members, a self-service, a do-it-for-yourself activity. It is not covered through production boundary, so therefore it is not included in estimating the gross domestic product of the country. So we should say it is a productive activity not covered through the production boundary. Therefore, it is not included in the GDP of the country as it is not covered through the production boundary. So transport facilities provided by a father to his children is disregarded when estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Next one. Cost incurred by the government on maintaining law and order of the country. The court system, police and all is maintained by the government, right? So for the betterment of the whole society, whole country, right? Government incurs a cost on it and providing these services to the economy. So it should be identified as a non-market production activity, should be identified as a non-market production activity. Therefore, it is covered through production boundary and included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Last one, value of biscuits produced by a biscuit manufacturing company. The biscuit manufacturing company is engaging in the business of manufacturing biscuits, aiming on selling them in the market at a price and making a certain profit. So therefore, it is a good produced by focusing on the market. A market-aimed production activity. A market-aimed production activity, which is covered through the production boundary. Therefore, it is included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. So this is how we should identify the economic activities which are included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country, and then the economic activities which are not included in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Right. So we will move on to the next question. This question is focusing on the way of arriving at the output concepts under the output approach. We are using the value added method in estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country under the output approach. So by doing this calculation, we will see how to obtain the output values under the output approach. We will read the question. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. All figures are in rupees millions. Gross value of output at basic price, taxes on product, net primary income from rest of the world, intermediary consumption, primary payments to the rest of the world, net taxes on product, subsidies on product net foreign current transfers. We are supposed to calculate gross value added at basic price, gross domestic product at market price, gross national income at market price, and then disposable gross national income at market price. So we will see how to do these calculations based on the given information. First of all, we will see how to calculate the gross value added at basic price. So they have given us the gross value of output. We symbolize it through GVO, gross value of output at basic price. I will present it in a short form. Gross value of output at basic price is given as 8,500. From this gross value of output at basic price, we need to deduct the intermediary consumption in arriving at the gross value added at basic price. We need to deduct the intermediary consumption. The intermediary consumption is given as 2,500. So when the intermediary consumption is deducted from the gross value of output, the answer what we get is identified as gross value added at basic price. So gross value added at basic price according to this question is 6,000. So this is how you should arrive at the answer for part A. Part B. We are supposed to calculate the gross domestic product at market price. Now we have the gross value added at basic price. Gross value added at basic price is how much? As we already calculated, it is 6,000. For this, we need to add net taxes on product. We need to add net taxes on product to the gross value added at basic price. The net taxes on product in this question is given as 2,000. So gross value added at basic price plus net taxes on product gives us the gross domestic product at market price. So this is how we calculate the gross domestic product at market price. Under the output approach. So we calculated the gross domestic product at market price. Now we will move on to the part C to calculate gross national income at market price. We will see how to calculate the gross national income at market price. So we already calculated the gross domestic product at market price and we obtained the answer as 8,000. Right, so how do we convert the gross domestic product at market price into the gross national income? Gross domestic product at market price, we already calculated. It same as 8,000. And then for the gross domestic product at market price, we need to add net primary income from rest of the world. I'm using ROW to represent rest of the world, right? Net primary income from rest of the world is given as 1,000. So this net primary income from rest of the world, 1,000, should be added to convert the gross domestic product into gross national income. So gross national income is obtained by adding the net primary income from rest of the world to the gross domestic product. So gross national income at market price is 9,000. So this is how we arrive at the answer for part C, gross national income at market price. Now we will move on to the part D, disposable gross national income at market price. The gross national income at market price is converted into the disposable gross national income. I will symbolize the gross national income at market price as GNI, and we already calculated it as 9,000. For the gross national income, we need to add the net foreign current transfers should be added to the gross national income. Net foreign current transfers is given as 2,500 here. So net foreign current transfers of 2,500 is added to the gross national income. The answer what we get is identified as the disposable gross national income. Identified as the disposable gross national income. Sometimes this is identified as gross national disposable income as well. Disposable GNI. So by using the output approach, we learned how to estimate the gross value added at basic price, right? Gross domestic product at market price, gross national income at market price, and then the disposable gross national income. But under the output approach, sometimes in a question they might have given the output values by dividing them into three categories as agricultural sector, industrial sector, and then the services sector. So at such a situation, if they have directly given us the gross value added in each sector, so we should add up the gross value added in agricultural sector, gross value added in industrial sector, and then the gross value added in services sector in order to calculate the gross value added at basic price, right? So we will now move on to the next question. Number 5. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. So some information is given. We are supposed to calculate the gross domestic product at market price, disposable gross national income, and then net national income at market price. So we will see how to do these calculations. So again, the gross value of output, I will use the GVO to identify the gross value of output at basic price, is given as 12,800. from the gross value of output and basic price, we need to deduct the intermediary consumption . The intermediary consumption is given as 2300. So when intermediary consumption is deducted from gross value of output, we will get gross value added at basic price, GVA at basic price. Right. So in part A, we are supposed to calculate the gross domestic product at market price. So once we obtain the gross value added at basic price, for this we need to add the net taxes on product to convert the gross value added at basic price in order to get the gross domestic product at market price. So you can see that in this question, net taxes on product is given as 1400. So for this we add net taxes on product . So the gross domestic product at market price is 11,900. Gross domestic product at market price is 11,900. So this is how we arrive at the gross domestic product at market price. And now we are supposed to convert this into the disposable gross national income. So first of all, the gross domestic product at market price should be converted into the gross national income, and then afterwards this should be converted into the disposable gross national income. So again, the gross domestic product at market price is 11,900. Gross domestic product at market price is 11,900 plus net primary income from rest of the world. Net primary income from rest of the world is directly given as 1,200. The answer what we get is identified as the gross national income at market price. So we added the net primary income from rest of the world, right? So we will get the GNI, the gross national income at market price. For the gross national income at market price, we need to add the net foreign current transfers to convert that into the disposable gross national income. One more thing in this question, at a situation where they have given us the net primary income from rest of the world, just because they are giving us primary payments to the rest of the world, we are not supposed to deduct it. Net primary income from rest of the world means primary income from rest of the world minus primary payments to the rest of the world. Primary income from rest of the world minus primary payments to the rest of the world is the net primary income from rest of the world. So at a situation where the net primary income from rest of the world is already given, at a situation where the net primary income from rest of the world is already given, we are not supposed to deduct the primary payments to the rest of the world again. It is already being deducted. So now, in order to convert the gross national income at market price to the disposable gross national income, we need to add the net foreign current transfers. We need to add the net foreign current transfers . So the net foreign current transfers is given as 2000 therefore, disposable gross national income is $15,100. Disposable gross national income is $15,100. And then part C is to calculate net national income at market price. All the gross concepts are converted into the corresponding net concept by deducting the consumption of fixed capital. In other words, by deducting capital depreciation. But in national accounting estimates, the capital depreciation are specifically termed as the consumption of fixed capital. Therefore, from the gross domestic product, when we deduct the consumption of fixed capital, we will get the net domestic product. From the gross national income, when we deduct the consumption of fixed capital, we will get the net national income. So in this question, we are supposed to calculate the net national income at market price. How do we do that? We already calculated the gross national income of this economy. The gross national income at market price is $13,100, right? So from this GNI at market price, gross national income at market price, which is $13,100, we need to deduct the consumption of fixed capital, how much is it? Consumption of fixed capital is given as 1,500. When this consumption of fixed capital is deducted from GNI at market price, you will get the net national income. Keep in your mind that from any gross concept, when you deduct the consumption of fixed capital, you will get the net concept. Of this economy. So based on this information, we learned how to calculate the gross domestic product at market price, disposable gross national income, and the net national income at market price. We will move on to the next question. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy, right? Compensation of employees, mixed income, primary income from rest of the world, net taxes on product, intermediary consumption, net operating surplus, primary payments to the rest of the world, net taxes on production and consumption of fixed capital are given. What we are supposed to do is to calculate the gross national income at market price. Gross national income at market price. This question is focusing on the income approach of estimating the GDP of a country. One thing you need to know is the approach matters only up to the point of reaching the gross domestic product at market price. Right? Only up to the point of reaching gross domestic product at market price, the approach matters. From that point onwards, every other concept is obtained in the same way for all the three approaches. So we will now see with this question how to estimate the value of the gross domestic product of the country using the income approach, as I already explained in the beginning. Under the income approach, we are estimating the value of the gross domestic product of the country using the factor incomes generated by providing factors of production to the production process. So the incomes earned by providing factors of production are divided into four categories under the income approach: as compensation of employees, operating surplus, mixed income, and then net taxes on production and imports. Compensation of employees identify the incomes earned by providing labor to the production process during the given period of time. The other three factors, land, capital, entrepreneurship, the incomes generated on those three factors are identified based on the ownership of those factors of production. The incomes earned by the incorporated business sector by providing their factors of production to the production process during the given period of time is identified under the topic of operating surplus, and the incomes generated by the unincorporated business sector, sole proprietorships, partnerships, and these kind of unincorporated business entities are also holding the ownership of some factors and generating incomes on those. So the incomes earned by these kind of unincorporated business entities by providing their factors of production to the production process is what we identify as the mixed income. So we will see by using this information how to estimate the value of cross-national income under the income approach. Right. So we will see. Compensation of employees under this kind of a situation, it is better if you prepare the whole format and apply the figures. Compensation of employees for this we need to add the gross operating surplus. Gross operating surplus is divided into three: as net operating surplus, mixed income, and then consumption of fixed capital. Right? For this, we need to add the net taxes on production. This is identified as net other taxes on production, or else you can take it as other taxes on production and imports less subsidies, right? The total of this is identified as the gross value added and basic price. Gross value added and basic price. So we will see. Compensation of employees is given as 4,300. Compensation of employees is given as 4,300. Right, next one, mixed income, 1,800. We'll write in a separate column. The next information, we are supposed to calculate gross national income at market price. I will first calculate the gross value added at basic price, and afterwards I will convert that into the gross domestic product and then into the gross national income at last. So I will not take the primary income from rest of the world into account, and as I'm estimating the GVA first. Net taxes on product is not needed here. Intermediary consumption is not taken into consideration under the income approach. Net operating surplus is given as 2,150. And then primary payments to the rest of the world. Net taxes on production is given as 1,400. Consumption of fixed capital is given as 900. total of these three is what we identify as gross operating surplus. The total of these three figures, 50, 10,550. Is the gross value added at basic price? But we are supposed to calculate the gross national income at market price. So we calculated gross value added at basic price and obtained the answer as 10,550. So again, gross value added at basic price is 10,550. For this, we need to add net taxes on product. Get the GDP at market price. The net taxes on product in this question is given as 1,350. 0 11,900 is the gross domestic product at market price. Right, gross domestic product at market price is how much? 11,900. We are supposed to calculate gross national income. So in order to convert gross domestic product at market price into the gross national income, we need to add the net primary income from rest of the world. So they have not directly given you the net primary income from rest of the world. Instead, they have separately given the primary income from rest of the world and then primary payments to the rest of the world. So for this, we need to add the net primary income from rest of the world. Primary income is 1,200. And primary payments is 2,000. Therefore, net primary income from rest of the world is minus 800. When that is adjusted here, you will get the gross national income at market price as 11,100. So this is how we calculate the gross national income at market price, 11,100. So this question explains how we should arrive at the gross national income at market price under the income approach. Right. Right, we will now move on to the question number 7. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. Some details are given. We are supposed to calculate the gross national income at market price and then the personal income. So if you carefully go through these details given here, you will realize that we will have to follow up the income approach in estimating the gross national income. But the focus of this question is actually not learning how to estimate the value of gross national income under the income approach. Why? In the previous question too, we learned how to arrive at the gross national income at market price. But in this question, I'm more focusing on the way of calculating the personal income. What do we mean by the gross national income first? The gross national income refers to the total income earned by the residents of a country by providing their factors of production to the production process during the given period of time. Gross national income refers to the total income earned by the residents of a country by providing their factors of production to the production process during a given period of time. Therefore, inside the gross national income of a country, we only identify the earned incomes. Only the earned incomes are included inside the gross national income of the country. Only the earned incomes are included. But then what do we mean by the personal income? Personal income refers to the income earned by the household sector. The income received by the household sector during a given period of time is what we identify as the personal income, or in other words, the household income. Not only the earned incomes are there inside the personal income, but also if any transfer income received by the household sector, that is also there inside the personal income. So once you calculate the gross national income of a country, from this gross national income, there are some income components which are not flown to the household sector of the economy. Inside the gross national income of a country, we find some income components which are not flown to the household sector of the economy. So from the gross national income, the incomes which are not flown to the household sector should be deducted when converting gross national income to the personal income. And afterwards, there are various transfer incomes which are received by the household. But as we already learned, only the earned incomes are there inside the gross national income. No transfer incomes are included inside the gross national income. But the households are receiving various transfers, and that is there inside the personal income. So therefore, these kind of transfer incomes received by the households, these kind of transfer income received by the household should be separately added in obtaining the personal income, or in other words, the household income. So we will see how to obtain the gross national income first and then to get the personal income. So as the details given here are related to the income approach, compensation of employees, for this you need to add gross operating surplus . We learned that gross operating surplus comprises of net operating surplus, mixed income, and then consumption of fixed capital. And then for this you need to add net taxes on production, or net other taxes on production, or taxes on production less subsidies. The answer what we get is identified as the gross value added and basic price. Is identified as the gross value added at basic price. So we will start to do the calculation. compensation of employees is given as 5,000. And there is some kind of a specific application in this question. The net operating surplus is not separately given in this question. As I already told you, under the net operating surplus, we identify the incomes earned by the incorporated business sector by providing their factors of production to the production process during the given period of time. The incomes earned by the incorporated business sector by providing their factors of production to the production process. Inside the net operating surplus, we identify some subcomponents. The rent income, the incomes earned by the incorporated business sector by providing their properties, the real assets to the production process during the given period of time. The net interest, the interest income earned by the incorporated business sector by providing the financial capital to the production process during the given period of time. And then the corporate profits. The corporate profit identifies the profits earned by the incorporated business sector during the given period of time. The corporate profits can be further divided into three as based on the way the net profit of an incorporated company is distributed. A part is paid to the government as corporate income taxes. A part is paid to the government as corporate income taxes. And then a part of the corporate profits is gone to the shareholders in terms of dividends. And then another part of it is maybe retained by the companies themselves in terms of retained profits of corporates, or in other words, the undistributed corporate profits. Or in other words, the undistributed corporate profits. So therefore, in this question, the net operating surplus is not separately given. Instead, the subcomponents of net operating surplus are given. So based on that, we are supposed to calculate the net operating surplus. So rent income, net interest are some subcomponents coming under the net operating surplus. So we will see rent income is 1,500, net interest is 2,200. Right. Pension income is not taken into consideration in national accounting estimates as it is a transfer income. Interest paid from government to households. The interest payments made by the government to the households or any other entity for the loans obtained by them is traditionally treated as a transfer payment and disregarded from the national accounting estimates. In one hand, it is argued that the government pays loans interest during this period for the past projects they've carried out, and therefore there is no current value addition through them. On the other hand, it is difficult to divide the government loans into two categories, as these are the loans obtained by the government for investment projects and these are for their current operational activities. Therefore, the total interest paid by the government on their loans is disregarded from national accounting estimates, and we identify that as a transfer payment. So we should not take that into consideration. Corporate income taxes is one component of corporate profits, so that should be gone under the net operating surplus. So corporate income taxes is 2,000. Right. And then dividends distributed by corporates is also a part of the corporate profits, so should be identified under the net operating surplus. So it is 1,700. Right. Mixed income 2,300. Right. consumption of fixed capital 1,800. Right. And then net taxes on production 1,200. And then net primary income from rest of the world minus 2,000. So that is not needed in arriving at the gross value added at basic price, and that is needed in converting GDP to gross national income. So that is now not needed for calculating gross value added. And net taxes on product is also not needed to get the GVA at basic price. So first of all, we will calculate the gross value added at basic price by adding these components. So the total of these four is $7,400. And then we will get the total of these three. The total of these three is the gross operating surplus. By adding these three, you can get the gross value added at basic price. So we get the gross value added at basic price as 17,700. Right, so like this we calculate the gross value added at basic price, but we are supposed to calculate the gross national income at market price, no? So should convert this GVA at basic price, which is 17,700, into GNI now. Right, GVA, gross value added at basic price. Always try to write the descriptive term without writing the symbols. 17,700. Right. And then for this, we need to add the net taxes on product to get the GDP at market price. Net taxes on product is given as 2,500. Taxes on product should add to the GVA at basic price. The net taxes on product is 2,500. 0,0. $20,200 is the gross domestic product at market price. So for the gross domestic product at market price, we need to add net primary income from rest of the world, net primary income from rest of the world, to convert the GDP at market price into the gross national income. The net primary income from rest of the world is given as minus 2,000. So that minus 2,000 should be added here. So you will get the gross domestic, the gross national income at market price is how much? 18,200. So gross national income at market price is 18,200. That's how you should answer the part A to calculate the gross national income at market price. Now we are supposed to convert this gross national income into the personal income. I told you, from gross national income, we should take off all the incomes which are not flown to the household sector. And for this, we need to add the household transfer receipts, PVC. So again, gross national income is 18,200. From this, we need to deduct the incomes which are not flown to the household sector, PVC. Corporate income taxes is there inside the gross national income. We took that into consideration when estimating the gross national income. But we know that all types of taxes are going to the government and not to the household sector. Therefore, that should be deducted from gross national income, right? Corporate income taxes should be deducted from gross national income. Why is it they are not going to the household sector? They are not going to the household sector, right? Corporate income taxes 2000. In addition, net taxes on production, net taxes on product, all types of taxes are not going to the household sector. They should also be deducted. Net taxes on production as well as product. So net taxes on production is 1,200. Net taxes on product is 2,500. Both types of taxes are not flown to the household sector. So these are the ones which should we deduct from gross national income when converting the gross national income into the personal income. So the total of these two is 5,700. So for this, we need to add all types of transfers received by the households. PVC, what types of transfers are here in this question? Pension income received by households is a transfer received by households. That's not there inside the gross national income, but are flown to the household sector. Interest paid from government to households, I told you that it is traditionally treated as a transfer payment, even though the question is not specifically telling you. We are supposed to take it as a transfer payment. So these are the transfers. Right? Household transfers. You can separately identify them. Pension. Interest from government, interest received from government. Right. So 2,600 plus 1,400 is 4,000. This should be added. So 16,500 is the personal income. So this is how we convert the gross national income at market price to the personal income, right? We will now move on to the question number 8. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. Exports, private consumption, expenditure, gross fixed capital formation, government purchases, net taxes on product, change in inventories, imports, net primary income from rest of the world, and then change in variables. We are supposed to calculate the gross national income at market price. So this question is focusing on arriving at the value of gross domestic product plus afterwards the gross national income using the expenditure approach. As we already discussed, under the expenditure approach, we are arriving at the value of the gross domestic product of the country. Under the expenditure approach, we are arriving at the value of the gross domestic product of the country based on the expenditure incurred on purchasing final goods and services during the given period of time. We are arriving at the value of the gross domestic product of the country based on the expenditure incurred on purchasing those goods and services, the final goods and services during the period being considered. So we will see based on this how to arrive at the value of the gross national income using the expenditure approach. The final expenses are divided into four categories under the expenditure approach: private consumption expenditure, government purchases, and then gross investments. When say gross investments expenditure, the gross investments expenditure has three subcategories: gross fixed capital formation, change in inventories, and then the change in valuables are the components of gross investments expenditure. So if they have directly given you gross investments expenditure, you can directly take it. But instead of giving you gross investments expenditure, if they have given you gross fixed capital formation, change in inventories, and then change in valuables, then you have to separately take them and add them together in arriving at the gross investments expenditure. So if you carefully observe this question, you will realize that here they have given you gross fixed capital formation separately, the change in inventories, and then the change in valuables separately. So you need to take them separately and add them together to get the gross investments. So under this we will say gross fixed capital formation then change in inventories and then change in valuables. Right? So we will see the the total of these three is identified as the gross domestic expenditure. Gross domestic expenditure. For the gross domestic expenditure, that is in other words for GDE, you need to add the net exports. When you add net exports to the gross domestic expenditure, the answer what we get is identified as the gross domestic product at market price. Under the expenditure approach, there is no need of separately adjusting for taxes, because under the expenditure approach, directly we are getting the values at the market price. So all types of taxes are included inside that. Therefore, we need to be aware that the taxes are not adjusted under the expenditure approach, right? So for when you add the net exports to the gross domestic expenditure, you will directly get the gross domestic product. You will get the gross domestic product. Right. So exports 1500. So first of all, they've given us the exports, so we can go to here. 1500 from exports, we need to deduct imports to get the net exports. Right. Private consumption expenditure 4800. Private consumption expenditure 4800. Gross fixed capital formation 4200, and then government purchases 3200. And then net taxes on product is not needed. I told you that we are not adjusting for taxes under the expenditure approach. So change in inventories is minus 200, right? Imports 2300, should deduct it from exports when arriving at the net exports. And then net primary income from rest of the world is needed in converting gross domestic product into the gross national income, so that we will separately take. Change in valuables is a part of the gross investments expenditure. It's given as plus 200. Total of these three is what we identify as gross investments. So these two are sitting off, so it is 4200. You should add these three and get the gross domestic expenditure. $12,200. Net exports 1500 minus 2800 is minus 800. Right, so gross domestic product at market price is 11,400. This is how we are arriving at the gross domestic product at market price under the expenditure approach. Right, now we will convert this into the gross national income at market price by adding the net primary income from rest of the world. The net primary income from rest of the world is given as minus 1000. Gross domestic product at market price is 11,400. For this, we need to add net primary income from rest of the world. It's minus 1000. So gross national income at market price is 10,400. So we learned with this question how to arrive at the gross national income at market price under the expenditure approach. As I already told you, the approach matters only up to the point of reaching the gross domestic product at market price. Once you reach to the gross domestic product at market price, from that point onwards, every other calculation is done in the same way. But here, we went up to the gross national income. So now we will move on to the next question. Question number 9. We will see. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. So some details are given. We are supposed to calculate gross domestic product at market price, gross national income at market price, domestic savings, the government purchases, national savings. So we will see private consumption, taxes on product, net primary income from rest of the world, gross operating surplus, gross fixed capital formation, primary payments to the rest of the world, net taxes on production, compensation of employees, net exports, net foreign current transfers is given there, and then change in inventories and subsidies on product. So when you read the question, you will see that some information from different approaches are given here. So at such a situation, by carefully going through the given information, you need to decide first of all which approach should be used in arriving at the GDP. You should see which information is given based on the information given. By using what approach, you can find out the gross domestic product. Now, as the private consumption expenditure is given on the top, if we think that if we see whether we can use the expenditure approach, we will see private consumption is given. The government purchases is needed here, it is not given. Right? And then we need the gross investments. For that, they have given you gross fixed capital formation. The change in inventories is given, even though the change in valuables is not there. It is not a reason to not to calculate gross investments if they have not given you the change in valuables. The value might be zero. So the problem is we are unable to use the expenditure approach in arriving at the GDP here. The reason is they have not given us the government purchases. So without having government purchases here, we are unable to use the expenditure approach in arriving at the GDP. So based on this information, we should realize that we should use the income approach in arriving at the GDP. You can see the compensation of employees is there, gross operating surplus is there, net taxes on production is there. Right, we'll see whether, net taxes on production is there. So we can use the income approach in arriving at the GDP. Right. So using the income approach, we will calculate the GDP. Compensation of employees. Then gross operating surplus, they have directly given us gross operating surplus, so you don't have to go for the subcomponents of it. Therefore, they have directly given you the gross operating surplus, and then net taxes on production. The total of these three should be identified as the gross value added at basic price. Right. Compensation of employees is 4,000. Gross operating surplus is given as 13,500. The net taxes on production is given as 3,000. So by adding these three, you can get the GVA at basic price. 20,500 GVA at basic price. For this, we need to add net taxes on product. Taxes on product, how much? The net taxes on product is not directly given here. Instead, taxes on product is given and the subsidies on product is given. Taxes on product is 2,500 and subsidies on product is 1,000. Right? 2,500. Minus 1,000. So net taxes on product is 1,500. By adding these together, you can get the gross domestic product at market price. The gross domestic product at market price is therefore how much? 22,000. So we calculated the gross domestic product at market price, the part A, by using the income approach. Now we will see how to calculate the gross national income at market price. We know that by adding net primary income from rest of the world, you can get the gross national income. In this question directly, they have given us the net primary income from the rest of the world, minus 2,000, right? So GDP at market price is 22,000, right? GDP at market price plus net primary income from rest of the world. Net primary income from rest of the world is how much? Minus 2,000. Therefore, gross national income at market price is, based on this explanation, 20,000. So this is how we arrive at the gross national income at market price, 20,000. And now we are supposed to calculate the domestic savings. We will see what is meant by the domestic savings. Domestic savings refer to from the gross domestic product of the country, the amount remained after consumption. From the gross domestic product of the country, the amount remained after consumption is what we identify as the domestic savings. So from the gross domestic product at market price, when we deduct the total consumption, which is the sum of private consumption expenditure, and then the government purchases, you will arrive at the domestic savings. Right? We will see. So gross national income at market price is 20,000. And gross domestic product at market price is 22,000. Right. So we are supposed to calculate the domestic savings. I told you that by deducting the total consumption from the gross domestic product at market price, we can arrive at the domestic savings. But the problem is, in order to calculate the total consumption, we need the private consumption as well as the government purchase. In this question, the government purchases are not given. So by directly using the formula gross domestic product at market price minus the total consumption, we cannot calculate the domestic savings. We know that under the expenditure approach, the value of the gross domestic product is calculated by adding up the private consumption, government purchases, gross investments, and then the net exports. Private consumption, government purchases, gross investments, and then net exports. The addition of all these four is identified as the gross domestic product at market price. From this gross domestic product at market price, when we deduct the total consumption expenditure, means the total of private consumption and government purchases only, we are getting the domestic savings. So private consumption plus government purchases plus gross investments plus net exports is GDP. From the GDP, when we deduct the first two, the private consumption and government purchases only, we are getting the domestic savings. So the domestic savings is, in other words, the total of the gross investments expenditure and then the net exports. Total of gross investments expenditure and then the net exports. So as we don't know the government purchases at this point, we know the gross investments, the gross fixed capital formation is given, the gross fixed capital formation is given, change in inventories is given. With that we can calculate the gross investments expenditure. The net exports is also directly given. So by adding up the net exports and gross investments, we can get the domestic savings. So we can form an equation saying domestic savings equal to gross investments plus gross investments plus net exports. So gross investments is the total of gross fixed capital formation and then the change in inventories. Gross fixed capital formation is 8,200, change in inventories is minus 200. So 8,200 minus 200. Net exports is given as minus 2,500. So plus into minus becomes minus, therefore this is 8,000 minus 2,500, domestic savings is 5,500. Domestic savings is 5,500, right? This is how we can calculate the domestic savings based on the given information. Next, we are supposed to calculate the government purchases, right? Now, we know the domestic savings and I told you that by deducting the total consumption from the GDP, we can get the domestic savings. Now we know the GDP, now we know the domestic savings. What we not know is the total consumption. So we can calculate the total consumption in order to get the government purchases. So domestic savings is 5,500. Domestic savings we already calculated 5,500. GDP we already calculated 22,000. What is not known is total consumption. Therefore, total consumption expenditure is 16,500. And the other thing is total consumption is 16,500. The total of private consumption and then government purchases. Private consumption plus the government purchases. In the question, the private consumption is already given as 8,000. This is 8,000. Total consumption is 16,500. What does it mean? The government purchases is 8,500. So this is how we can arrive at the government purchases. The government purchases is 8,500. Thank you. Understood up to this point. Last part is to calculate the national savings. National savings means from the disposable gross national income of the country. National savings means from the disposable gross national income of the country. The amount remained after consumption is what we identify as the national savings. Now, therefore, from the disposable gross national income, we need to deduct the total consumption expenditure in arriving at the national savings. Now, we calculated the gross national income in the previous, in part B, we calculated gross national income. The gross national income is converted into disposable gross national income by adding up the net foreign current transfers. You can see that net foreign current transfers are given here, right? Gross national income is 20,000 plus net foreign current transfers 1,500. Disposable gross national income is 21,500. From that, the total consumption should be deducted. Now, we've already calculated the total consumption is how much? 16,500. So, therefore, national savings is 16,500. Now the total consumption is already found out, 16,500. The disposable gross national income is not given, but we can calculate it. We already calculated the gross national income as 20,000. For this, we need to add the net foreign current transfers to get the disposable gross national income. The net foreign current transfers is given as 1,500 here, right? So minus total consumption expenditure, 16,500. So this is 20,000. Minus total consumption expenditure 16,500. National savings is 5,000. So this is how we calculate the national savings. We got national savings as 5,000. So with this calculation, we learned the application of domestic savings as well as the national savings, right? Question number 10. following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. Some details are given here. We are supposed to calculate the gross domestic product at market price, the disposable gross national income, the national savings, and then the net exports. We will see. Right. First of all, we will see how to get the gross domestic product at market price. If you carefully go through these given details, the aggregate consumption function is given here, but the gross investments are not given in the question. The gross investments are not given in the question. Instead, they have given us the domestic savings and then the gross domestic expenditure. So, we discussed in the previous question that the domestic savings can be calculated by adding up the net exports and gross investments. Domestic savings is there, but again the net exports is not there, so we cannot calculate it in that way. But then gross domestic expenditure is given in this question. The gross domestic expenditure is the total of private consumption expenditure, the government purchases, and then the gross investments. The total of private consumption expenditure and the government purchases is what we identify as the aggregate consumption. Now the aggregate consumption is given here, and then the gross domestic expenditure is also given here. So then we can form an equation saying gross domestic expenditure equals to aggregate consumption, means the total of private consumption and government purchases, plus the gross investments. Right, what we are supposed to find in part A is to calculate the gross domestic product at market price. We are given the gross domestic expenditure. So to convert gross domestic expenditure into the gross domestic product, what we need is net exports. The net exports is not given in this question. The net exports is not given in this question. That is why we have to go in some kind of an indirect method to do this conversion. So the objective of doing this calculation is to calculate the gross investments. With that we can find out a method of getting the net exports. So gross investments. GDE is 10,000 and aggregate consumption is 7,500. So what is not known to us is the gross investments expenditure. So gross investments expenditure is 2,500. Gross investments expenditure is 2,500. So now we can say domestic savings equal to gross investments plus net exports. So gross investments is 2,500 and net exports is what we are finding out, and the domestic savings is 3,500. Therefore net exports is 2005. Sorry. -2,500 is net exports. Net exports is 1,000. Net exports is 1,000. So GDE, gross domestic expenditure, is there, which is 10,000. plus net exports 1000, GDP is 11,000. So this is when you go along with the formal procedure. But we can calculate the gross domestic product in another way as well. As we already discussed, domestic savings is the GDP at market price minus total consumption. Domestic savings is 3,500, total consumption is 7,500. Therefore, when this minus 7,500 is taken to the other side, you will get the GDP. So the value of the gross domestic product is 11,000. So in this way also we can calculate the gross domestic product, and the gross domestic product is 11,000. The next one is to calculate the disposable gross national income. To calculate the disposable gross national income, the gross domestic product is there with us. Right. So when the GDP is there with us, we can convert that into GNI by adding the net primary income from rest of the world and obtain the GNI. So GNI plus net foreign current transfers is the disposable GNI. So net secondary income from rest of the world is another way of identifying the net foreign current transfers. So we will convert this into the disposable GNI. Now GDP is 11,000. Disposable GNI is equal to GDP plus net primary income from rest of the world is GNI plus net foreign current transfers, or in other words, net foreign secondary income. We already calculated the GDP and obtained the answer as 11,000. Net primary income is not directly given, but primary income is 1,750. Primary payments to the rest of the world is 2,500. 1,750 minus 2,500 is the net primary income. Is the net primary income, and the net secondary income is 2,250. So this is 1,750 minus 2,500 is 750, but it is minus. Plus 2,250. So plus into minus is minus. Minus 750 plus 2,250 is plus 1,500. So the disposable gross national income is 12,500. Disposable gross national income is 12,500. So we calculated the disposable gross national income, right? Now we are supposed to find out the national savings, as we discussed in the previous question. from the disposable gross national income. When we deduct the aggregate consumption expenditure, we can calculate the national savings. So we will calculate the national savings. National savings equal to disposable gross national income. Minus total consumption expenditure. Or in other words, the aggregate consumption expenditure. We got the disposable GNI as 12,500. From that, we need to deduct the total consumption. The total consumption is given as 7,500. Therefore, national savings is exactly 5,000. National savings is exactly 5,000. Right. We calculated the national savings also. Now we will calculate the net exports. Actually, we already calculated net exports in arriving at the gross domestic product in the long procedure, but I will show the calculation of net exports here. Right, we will see how to get that. We calculated the national savings, so we will see how to calculate the net exports. So we can form an equation saying gross domestic product is equal to gross domestic expenditure plus net exports. Now the gross domestic expenditure is given as 10,000 in the question. Gross domestic expenditure is given as 10,000, and we already calculated the gross domestic product and we got the answer as 11,000. So plus net exports is the GDP. No, gross domestic expenditure plus net exports is GDP. So GDP is 11,000, GDE is 10,000. Therefore, the net exports of the economy should be 1,000. Right. So this is how we can calculate the net exports of the economy. We will move on to the next question. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. Disposable gross national income, balance of current account of BOP, domestic savings, government purchases, net primary income from the rest of the world. So based on this information, we are supposed to calculate the gross investments, the private consumption expenditure, the gross domestic product at market price, and then the national savings at last. First of all, we will see how to calculate the gross investments. Actually, we can easily calculate the gross investments based on this information. We already calculated the domestic savings using the equation domestic savings equal to gross investments plus the net exports. Here in this question, they've given us the domestic savings. They've given us the domestic savings and they have given us the net exports. In that equation, the only absent information is gross investments. So by using that equation, you can directly get the gross investments expenditure. Right? The gross investments is, we will say in this way, we will write down the equation for domestic savings. domestic savings equal to gross investments plus net exports. Gross investments plus net exports. The domestic savings is 3,500, net exports is minus 1,000. So we are supposed to calculate the gross investments. So plus into minus is minus 1,000. The minus 1,000 becomes 3,000 plus 1,000 in the other side. So therefore, gross investments should be 4,500. Or in other words, when you deduct 1,000 from 4,500, you will get 3,500. So therefore, gross investments expenditure of this economy is 4,500. Gross investments expenditure of this economy is 4,500. Next question is to calculate the private consumption expenditure, PVC. Government purchases is there. The domestic savings is there. And we are supposed to calculate the private consumption expenditure. Right, we already calculated the gross investments here. The gross investments of this economy is 4,500. So we should find out a method of getting the private consumption expenditure with the help of the available information. Right, so the domestic savings we will see. So we can calculate the gross domestic expenditure of the economy by deducting the balance of current account of BOP from the disposable gross national income. The balance of current account of BOP comprises of three major sub-accounts. The balance of current account of BOP comprises of three major sub-accounts. The three major sub-accounts of the balance of current account or the inside the current account of BOP are the goods and services account. The goods and services account shows the net exports of the country. And in the primary income account, the balance of the primary income account shows the net primary income from rest of the world. And then the balance of the secondary income account, the secondary income account shows the net foreign current transfers. So if you have the gross domestic expenditure with you, that you can convert into the GDP by adding the net exports of the country. Net exports is shown through the balance of goods and services account of the current account. And the gross domestic product is converted into the gross national income by adding the net primary income from rest of the world. As I told you, the net primary income is shown through the primary income account of the current account of BOP. And then the gross national income is converted into the disposable gross national income by adding the net foreign current transfers. The net foreign current transfers are shown through the secondary income account balance of the current account of BOP. So, therefore, the gross domestic expenditure plus the current account of BOP gives you the disposable GNI. Because inside the current account, we find net exports, we find net primary income, and we find the net secondary income, or in other words, the net foreign current transfers. So with the help of that relationship, we can find out the gross domestic expenditure. That is GDE. So we can directly say GDE equals to disposable gross national income minus balance of current account of BOP. Balance of current account of BOP. Disposable GNI is 12,000. balance of current account of BOP is given as 1500. So therefore, the gross domestic expenditure of this economy is 10,500. But we know that GDE is the sum of private consumption, government purchases, and then gross investments. Gross investments we already found out in the previous calculation as 4,500. Right? Gross domestic expenditure is obtained from the previous calculation. It is 10,500. What we are supposed to find is private consumption expenditure, and they have given us the government purchases. Government purchases is 2000. What is not known is private consumption, and what we are supposed to find is also the same, private consumption expenditure. If you simplify this equation, right, you can get the sum of these two is 6500 is deducted from 10,500. You will get this as 4,000. So therefore, private consumption expenditure of this economy is 4,000. Private consumption expenditure of this economy is 4,000. Last one is to calculate the national savings. Now we have the disposable GNI with us, and then from that we need to deduct the total consumption. The total consumption is the sum of private consumption expenditure and then the government purchases. We calculated the private consumption in the previous section is 4,000, government purchases is 2,000. That total can be deducted from the disposable GNI to get the national savings. The government purchases is 2,000. National savings is disposable gross national income minus total consumption. Disposable GNI is given in the question as 12,000. Total consumption is private consumption plus government purchases. Therefore, national savings is 6,000. Right? National savings is 6,000. So this is how we calculate the national savings based on this given information. But in another way, we can calculate the national savings by adding up the balance of the current account of BOP to the gross investments as well. As we already calculated the gross investments at the beginning of the question, directly by adding the gross investments and the balance of current account of BOP also, we can get the national savings. That's another way of calculating the national savings of this economy. Right? So we will move on to the next question. Right, we'll read the question. Following details are given in relation to a hypothetical economy. Final consumption expenditure, net taxes on product, gross fixed capital formation, net exports, balance of current account of BOP, change in inventories, and then change in valuables. We will see what are required to do. Gross domestic product at market price, disposable gross national income, and then national savings. So we are supposed to calculate these three by using the given information. So again, by looking at this, you can see that you are supposed to use the follow up the expenditure approach in doing these calculations. The Gross investments expenditure of the economy can be calculated by adding up gross fixed capital formation, change in inventories, and then the change in valuables. Net exports is there, and then the final consumption is also there. So by using the direct method of estimating the GDP under the expenditure approach, we can calculate the gross domestic product at market price in this question, right? Here the final consumption expenditure is standing for the total consumption expenditure, which is the total of private consumption expenditure and then the government purchases. So PVC, final consumption expenditure, plus gross investments, plus net exports. We will first get the gross domestic expenditure. For the gross domestic expenditure, when you add the net exports, you will get the gross domestic product at the market price. Right, we'll go for calculation. Final consumption expenditure is given as 7,200. Gross investments is not directly given you, but gross fixed capital formation is given, the change in inventories is given, and then the change in valuables is given. So by adding up all those three, you can get the gross investments expenditure. Gross fixed capital formation 3,200, change in inventories 200, change in valuables 100. So it is 3,500. The total of these two gives you the gross domestic expenditure. How much is it? 10,700. For this, you need to add the net exports is given as minus 2,000. Right, net exports is given as minus 2,000, so that should be added here. So if we get the gross domestic product at market price, $8,700 is the gross domestic product at market price of this economy. So we calculated the gross domestic product at market price. Now we will see how to calculate the disposable gross national income. We will see how to calculate the disposable gross national income based on this information. We know that when you, like in the part A, we calculated the GDP at market price. So from GDP at market price, to convert that into the disposable gross national income, we need to add the net primary income and then the net foreign current transfers. The problem is they have not separately given us the net foreign current transfers and then the net primary income from rest of the world in this question. So we have to think of another way of obtaining the disposable gross national income in this question. Right. So based on this information, if you can remember the calculation we did, we already calculated the gross domestic expenditure of the economy. Gross domestic expenditure of this economy is how much? 10,700. The gross domestic expenditure is how much? 10,700. The gross domestic expenditure is converted into gross domestic product by adding net exports. And we get the GDP. GDP is converted into gross national income by adding up the net primary income. So we get the GNI. And then GNI plus the net foreign current transfers is the disposable GNI. So in another way, for gross domestic expenditure, we should add the net exports, net primary income, and then the net secondary income to get the disposable GNI. As I already explained at the beginning of this discussion, the total of net exports, net primary income, and then the net foreign current transfers is given through what? the current account balance of the BOP. So they have given us the current account balance of the BOP. So as we already have the gross domestic expenditure with us, and also the question has given you the balance of current account of BOP, by adding them together you can get the disposable gross national income. So disposable gross national income is gross domestic expenditure, we already calculated, plus balance of current account of BOP. The current account of BOP is given as how much? 2400 here. Therefore, the disposable gross national income is 13,100. Disposable gross national income is how much? 13,100. And then last part of the question, national savings. So we already learned that the national savings is the disposable gross national income. From the disposable gross national income of the economy, the amount remained after consumption only is identified as the national savings. So from the disposable gross national income of the economy, when the total consumption expenditure is deducted, we will be arriving at the national savings. Here the final consumption expenditure means, in other words, the total consumption expenditure is given as 7,200, and we already calculated the disposable gross national income in the previous part. It is 3,100. So therefore, 13,100. We can say disposable gross national income minus total consumption or final consumption in other words. The disposable gross national income, as we calculated, is 13,100. The final consumption expenditure is 7,200. We get the value of national savings as 5,900. So this is how we calculate the national savings of this economy. So we discussed about the national accounting estimates today. So we tried to identify how to identify the economic activities in estimating the value of the gross domestic product at the beginning. And then by using various calculations, we showed how the value of the gross domestic product and the related concepts are estimated by using the three approaches: output approach, income approach, and then the expenditure approach. So thank you, you got a comprehensive understanding regarding the way of arriving at these national accounting estimate concepts using these different approaches with this discussion. So the objective of these calculations is to give an understanding regarding the way of calculating these different concepts using different approaches. So I think you understood these explanations we did up to this point. So we will meet with another discussion like this, focusing on the other lessons. So thanking to the Bank of Ceylon for giving me this great opportunity to contribute this, we will wind up the discussion for today.